new series of challenge. We're in London this week, as usual. We're not quite sure what's going on, except I'm convinced Dave has got something to do with us. Are you, Dave?
I'm not at all. I don't know where we're going anyway.
Wormwood Scrubs.
Ah.
It's all we've been told, to go to the most famous prison in Britain. It's in West London. I think it's the entrance is just down here. And I really am completely baffled, Dave.
Parking tickets, I think.
It's those dodgy videos, isn't it? Should we just go in? What's that barking? Oh, look, the doors are opening. I'm not getting out. I'm just not getting out. There's a police van arriving. What is going on? We're outside Wormwood Scrubs now. And there's some light-fingered Fred and Dirty Bertie are just arriving to be locked up, obviously.
Come on, Anneka, do you challenge in here?
What is it? Do you know? Is there something in that van for us?
Nothing.
It's convicts. Well, that's the prison in there. I don't think they wanted us to go in there. Dave, this is baffling. We're meant to get up this wall, or someone's going to let down a knotted sheet, or...
Keep on running. Keep on hiding. One fine day, I'm going to be the...
Hello. Can't get in, can you?
Main entrance.
Yeah, we tried that. They shut the door in our face. Dave, you're not as fit as you were last year.
It's a long way.
Well, we've been round and we can't get in. It's a horse. Hello. Lovely. See the prison here. And I cannot work out what we're going to do, huh? Oh! Hello. My name is Quizzy. Ride me in the 3:15 race for the challenge trophy at the 1994 Wormwood Scrubs Indoor Riding School Gymkhana this Thursday, PTO. The race won't start until you've built the indoor riding school. 66-1, you can't do it in time. This is hysterical. Just untethered him and he's taken off at a fair old brisk walk. Are we going home? This is the way. No, no, don't trot. Don't trot. Don't trot. Don't trot. Don't trot. Don't trot. No, don't trot, Quizzy. Look, slow down. There we go. Good boy. Girl? He's off again. What? Eureka, there are some ponies ahead of us. Hello? Do I take it that at long last you're something to do with the challenge?
I'm Mary Joy.
Mary Joy.
Yes, and
hello.
This is Joey.
Hello, Joey.
One of our little lads.
So what is this all about? It says indoor riding school?
Yes. We have a pony centre at Wormwood Scrubs. And
for the prison?
Not for the prison. Where? We involve the prisoners there.
Right.
We have them there as volunteers. We're associated to riding for the disabled. We have young children from inner London that normally wouldn't have the opportunity of riding, and they are members of the pony club.
Mary Jo, I don't want you to think I'm not adept at handling ponies, but Quizzy and I haven't got off to a good start, I have to say.
And he's now saying I'm going to show off to my friends out in the paddock. Anneka, come
with
back
you in a minute.
Anneka. What we try to do is mix some of our special needs riders with the so-called able-bodied riders.
So the architect is lurking here. Hello! Nice to meet you. Who's who?
Sarah Granville, architect.
Sarah, hi.
We're Anne Page from the Taylorwood Road.
So how far has this project got then up to today? You've done a bit of local volunteer work, you said.
We have. Sarah has been a long friend of the Pony Centre. And as she is an architect, obviously I have...
Nobbled her.
Bram is willing to be...
You're on for this.
I am. Give it a go.
This is a serious construction.
It's an amazing structure. We've got a whole steel frame inside the building. The top of the model comes off so you can see.
Yeah.
We've got this steel frame around the perimeter to basically erect first.
Yeah.
Obviously all the groundworks to go with it.
Yeah.
Then we have the roof to put on, which looks very nice and easy when it goes on like that.
But is it all in bits?
It will all be in loads of bits.
Yeah.
I have here a list of all the components, or certainly most of the components that we'll need for the building, which you ought to have.
Which runs to several pages.
Well, it does, certainly. It's a fair watch, and it covers everything. I'll hand it to you.
Oh, God. Fencing systems, wood, electricity.
Mary Joy, are the horses going to be all right with all this noise going on?
Well, I would be happier if they were actually out of the yard before any of that happened. And I would suggest if we could put up a temporary stable site somewhere on the scrubs.
Okay, so that's the first thing, to sort out the horses here. And you've got a gang of men who can
get you a gang of men. Just one gang?
As a matter of urgency, Mary Jo is phoning a temporary stabling company she knows, LH Woodhouse, because the horses here need to be rehoused. But we need lots of materials ordered, so let's start here. Yeoman aggregates we need to ring now. We need things like, what's sharp sand, Dave? Scalping mix.
Yeoman, good afternoon.
Oh, hi there. It's Anneka Rice here from the Challenge Programme.
Hello.
Hello. I gather you're in Acton.
I am indeed, yes.
Will you be able to help us, do you think?
Yes, I think we can.
Really, you are brilliant. Just ringing a company called Natter Construction, who hopefully might be able to help out with some JCBs, labourers and... Is that too noisy?
I can't hear anything, though.
What is it? Where is it coming from?
Good afternoon, Natter Construction.
Hello there. Could I talk to someone about helping out possibly with a challenge we're doing? It's Anneka Rice here.
One moment, please.
Thank you. Is that okay with that wretched dog?
I can't hear anything on the island.
Elbows your side, please, and chin up.
Good afternoon, Travis Perkins.
Oh, hello there. Could I talk to someone about vertical timber cladding?
Vertical timber cladding? Yeah, how can I help you?
Who's that?
It's Ian Church.
Hello, Ian. It's Anneka Rice from the Challenge Programme.
Good gracious. Hello, Anneka.
What's that noise, Dave?
Right.
Sorry, I've got a mad barking noise. That's not down your end, is it?
I don't think
so. Okay. Can you hang on a second? There's this...
Of course I can,
what,
yeah.
There's a dog. Sorry, Ian.
That's
two
all right.
Seconds.
No problem.
What's going on? What's going on?
Pedro! Echo, Echo, you weren't meant to be barking. I thought we'd had an agreement.
Yes.
Well, this is Pedro, it's my little dog. I can't leave him at home.
But little dog. He's barking all morning, Dave.
Well, maybe he could just tag along with us and then he'd be quiet. He'd be alright. He's very good, though.
We have an arrival. Hooray, at last. Arrival. Through there. Now we just need the weather. What we're doing in this huge open space now is trying to get away from the main noise, find somewhere calm and protected, and then move all the ponies away from the site to this temporary stable, which will be built. Watch this space. So I think it seems like a good spot.
London Electricity Contracting Limited.
Oh, hi there. Oh, Steve Shine's office.
Well, we're going to start this job, haven't we, lad?
Well, let's go. Yeah.
Can I talk to Mr. Shine?
One moment.
Brilliant name for someone in an electricity company. Hello. Schmoozing, are we, Mr. Shine?
Hi, Steve Shine.
Hello there. Hi there. Is that, that's British Steel Services Centre, is it?
That's correct.
Hi, it's Anneka Rice from the Challenge Programme. Now, where might we get some steel from, would you think?
Well, you come to the right people.
So obviously while they're walking through, if we can just keep the noise down. But thanks very much indeed. Hello, Joey. We have some temporary lodgings just for a couple of nights.
I think that's fairly good odds. It's going to be a real struggle to finish it on time. We're just about on programme, maybe a little behind at the moment.
Why are you behind already, do you think?
Well, partly because we couldn't get the horses out in time, but now they're out there, so we're able to work right up close to the stables. Yeah, that's our basic problem. We started a bit later than we'd hoped.
The sun is setting, it's now 9:30, but in fact it's just the beginning of a very long night for most people here. Good news though, a company up in Aberdeenshire called R.B. Farker have said they'll build us two modular buildings, and they're like sort of ready-made buildings that they can literally slot in over here, and there'll be a shower and a loo there and a reception room. Robinson Construction in Derby, we've just heard that they can collect the steel from BSD Steel Service Centre and deliver it to us, and the concrete is actually going in now. Pioneer Wilmot are laying that at the moment, so hopefully the steel can be set tomorrow. And look at this beautiful fence. I'm sorry to be so poetic, but just a few hours ago this was just an empty bit of field, and now we have a home for the ponies, so hopefully at least they can get a good night's sleep tonight. We've got to ride in a Dukana together on Thursday. Seem to have got that bonding very well sorted out with Quizzy. I've just come to say goodnight. Sleep well. Goodnight. From yesterday afternoon. As you can see, there is now some sort of semblance of a riding school. The concrete piles have gone in, the steel frames are going up, and something else going on this morning is this. Okay, this isn't for you. Hello? Anyone alive? Good morning. Breakfast time. Look, what do we have? Breakfast in bed, this is. Which is you, Sister Mary Joy? How are the horses, the ponies?
The horses have had a wonderful holiday. They really, really are enjoying themselves. And they've been eating grass all night and just lying down out there, and they think we're absolutely cracked.
So they think they've died and gone to heaven. It seems as good a time as any to actually say that Mary Joy is a nun. I'd like to ask what she's doing lying down in a bed of straw.
I've been with horses all my life.
Yeah.
And when I entered, I gave them up. Then a few years later, I was asked if I'd be interested in taking on this project. I said yes, and here I am back with horses living in stables.
Teamwork going.
What?
And my voice is gone.
Can I introduce you to Rod Stewart here?
Yes.
What happened? You've been shouting at people.
Shouting at everyone all night, getting them on, motivating them. And my voice is totally gone now. It's great teamwork here. Everyone is really working hard.
Excellent. Nothing to do with the quality of the bacon sandwiches in the tea.
Oh, I'm sure it is, yeah.
We're after today is some small force, workforce, to work on the stables.
Well, you know where you get them from.
Well, we thought we'd try the prison.
Oh, wonderful idea.
Why not? Does anyone see my bacon sandwich? Of a truck driver called Willie Adam, who's bringing down this modular building from Aberdeenshire.
Hello?
Is that Willie?
Yes.
Willie, good day. It's Anneka here from the Challenge Programme.
Oh, hello, Anneka. How are you doing?
Okay. How are you doing, more to the point?
Oh, we're doing all right now. We're on the A1 now, off of the M25, so we must be heading in the right direction.
Oh, you've made really good progress, Willie.
Oh, not too bad. Yeah.
See you later. Hello, we're going to a prison. Okay? Have you had your breakfast? No. Poor thing. Hasn't had anything to eat yet this morning, have you, darling? Oh, I've always wanted to do this day, but I'm extremely excited. Hello?
Who is it you're going to see?
The governor.
The governor? Okay. Yes. I'm not quite sure about the dog.
That's not a dog, that's Pedro.
Well, Pedro. Because we got some big dogs in there walking in. I shouldn't like Pedro to be at up by
now. Oh, he's a tough dog. Yeah. Right. Pedro couldn't stand his patch, can't you, Pedro? Terrifying guard dog.
All round to the right, okay?
Pedro, this is our big moment. Thank you. Down here. Thank you. Really got to meet Pedro.
No.
Pedro, be butch, okay? Think big and tough. Okay?
Aaron.
Hello there. Thank you for allowing this invasion. Thank you very much. Keith, Dave.
Hello.
The dog in the car. We're doing a challenge. I don't know whether you've ever seen the programme.
Yes, I have.
You have. And we have a short time to achieve a project, and we're actually working with a riding school, and we have reached a bit of a dilemma in that we need some extra men, and I just wondered whether you had a few kind of guys hanging around not doing much today might like a trip out in the fresh air, or are they allowed out?
Yes, Dick, we could use the prisoners that are already cleared, security cleared for community service.
What does security cleared mean?
People who are Category D.
What does that mean?
That means that they could be in open prisons if they weren't in Wormwood Scrubs, where there's no risk to the public, really. Okay, we can use those, prepare the licences, but they have to be volunteers.
Right, terrific. Well, thank you very much for that.
Yeah.
We'll go and see if anyone
good
volunteers.
Luck with the, good luck
if no
with
one
the
volunteers, I'm coming back for you.
It's a pleasure. We'll do our best.
Okay, thank you very much.
Bye bye.
Oh, so the guys you think will be able to volunteer for our work, what are they in for?
I honestly don't know on this lot, but they are. I do know that they are handpicked to go on that kind of work. All these chaps will be working. Some of them might be working around the Pony Centre anyway, so they'll know the place that you go into.
Okay.
And others work in various other community projects.
Hello. We were wondering if anyone fancied a day in that lovely fresh air, working near nature.
Yeah.
Anywhere on for it? Really?
Yeah.
Oh, brilliant, thank you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. So, will you walk there, or...?
Yeah. Or the buggy.
You can come in the buggy then. All right, you're in the buggy. You asked for it. What are you in for, she said, just wanting to check this.
Me?
Yeah.
What am I at?
Not stealing cars or anything.
No. I got charged for murder, and I won my appeal 21st of January this year.
Right.
And I'm just doing, finishing off a 7-year sentence for GBH.
Right.
But I like to say I didn't do it.
Right, okay.
Seriously.
Right.
That's another story anyway.
Okay.
Yeah?
Okay.
I'll come with you anyway.
Right.
If you want me to.
A bit nervous. He's okay.
I'm fine.
God, sort of a hot flush coming on here.
We'll make sure he comes back.
He'll come back. I know he'll come back.
See you later.
Bye.
Bye.
Do you do a lot of community work then?
Well, since I've been in prison, I've been doing it. I've never done it before.
Right.
But since I came into prison, I've got into it, put it that way. A couple of years ago, when I saw handicapped people, I would have said, ugh. But you'll never hear that from me now, anyway.
So So this is the stable block, which needs repainting and varnishing up and everything. I can't believe I've got your dog, Dave. I can't believe I've swung round in my opinion of it. You're lovely, Pedro. Matthew. Hiya, how are you doing?
All right, not too bad.
This is Michael, and there's six others coming from the prison to help you. Okay?
So we should get it done on time then.
Yeah. I hope so. Pedro, no. He's deeply impressed. He thinks that's a mud bath or a bowl of chocolate.
Good afternoon, Hickson.
Is that Hickson's Timber Products?
It is.
Hi.
Hunter Timber, good afternoon.
That's Hunter Timber in Tilbury.
It is, yes.
Oh, right.
Welcome back for good morning.
Can you hear me all right? I'm up in a crane.
Yeah, just about.
We've got the best view up here in a crane. You can really see the scale of the project now and how much has been achieved. The Essenes has been put on the roof there by BFR roof sheeting. And you can see the whole structure. Beyond that, there's the stables. Everyone's working flat out. And over there, you can just make out the temporary stables where the horses are taking refuge for the moment.
Oh,
hello there. Could I talk to someone about roller shutter steel doors?
Good afternoon, Steelway Fence Secure.
Hi. Is that Steelway Fence Secure?
That's right.
Sorry, I'm sitting on a slag heap. I can't hear you properly. Oliver Skeet, thank you so much for coming along.
My pleasure.
Show jumper supremo. It's a lovely centre though, isn't it?
Brilliant. I love the work you're doing here. Now, for the kids with special needs, I mean, I've seen them on horses and they absolutely enjoy it, so...
Yeah, so... Oh!
Look at this!
Oh, you...
OK, what we're going to do now, we're going to do some exercises, OK? So you have to watch me and do what as I do, OK? Hands above your head. Hands out. Both hands on your nose. On your mouth. Touch your knees. On your head. Both hands on your head. That's a good girl. Up in the air. That's a lovely boy, Simon.
That's it.
That's absolutely brilliant. Well done. That was absolutely lovely. I hope you all enjoyed that.
How old are you, Simon?
He's seven.
Seven years old. Big.
Oh, Robbie.
How's it going? How does it help him?
His coordination. He used to be terrified of animals, and as you can see, he's quite fearless now, yeah. And it's been a marvellous experience for him.
And how do you think the new arena, the new covered ring will help the club?
Really super.
Who knows Wheels on the Bus? Should we start singing it then, yeah? The wheels on the bus go round and round, round and round, round and round.
We'll leave Oliver to carry on with his lesson. We've just heard brilliant news. Willie has made it down the motorway. He's about to arrive at the modular building. Willie's made it! Are you Willie? Willie! Well driven!
Hey, just follow it. Follow it.
That way. But you've got a column coming up here, so he's got to go further that way. Must do. Oh, well, that's what we're doing then.
It's very tense. This is the first modular building. It's got to be very carefully placed now on the concrete. Quite nerve-wracking this, and then the whole process will have to be repeated all over again with the second building, and it's only then that the services like London Electricity can get in and start connecting things. Michael! How are you doing? Work of art!
Yeah, we're nearly finished.
Look, we're going to be in deep trouble unless you're back by 6:30. The governor will be locking us all up.
Okay.
No, seriously, what about the time?
Time, it's only 6 o'clock. Yeah, we've got a bit more time. I wish I could stay all night.
Yeah.
Just complain about it.
Are you enjoying it?
Yeah, of course I am.
Hi.
Not quite so clean now, are we?
They were personal whiteness.
I know. These two arrived looking like a soap commercial. And you've got a bit dribbly down your legs.
Well, it's the only chance we get getting new overalls, you see.
Oh, really? Something like this, so it's a matter of plastering all the mud on that you've
Make sure we don't have to send them back.
This is incredible. Just 28 hours into the project. I cannot believe the transformation from the green field that was here yesterday. It's looking almost complete, but obviously it's not. There's so many more details to be put onto it. There's the electricians are in at the moment. Here's Bram, who's slightly gone. A few grey bits, I feel, on that beard today.
There's a few there, aren't there?
What are the problems you've got tonight, for example?
We've still got a lot of work to do. All the cladding going around the building. The roof is still to be complete. It might look like a fairly finished building, but there's an awful lot to do.
Downpours this morning, which has not helped us at all.
Have you just arrived?
We arrived at 7 this morning and it was raining.
I know, don't mention the rain. We're trying to pretend it hasn't been raining for morale reasons.
Well, I wish you could bring some influence on the weather.
Sister Mary Joy, there was a downpour a couple of hours ago.
But it's stopped now. The sun will be out in a minute.
Okay.
Definitely.
You've got that on good authority,
yes.
That's all right then.
Mark my word.
Okay, well watch this space.
We haven't been let down so far.
What do you think anyway, seeing it happening?
It's absolutely incredible.
So exciting,
I mean,
isn't
it's
it?
It's exciting, it's wonderful. It's a fairy story.
Fairy story.
Yeah, come true.
Hello. That dog is not safe on that construction site without a hard hat.
Off you go. Strong legs, nudge. Well done, keep nudging, that's good.
It is now pouring with rain, but life at the centre is still going on. There's a class book, so lessons are as normal in our temporary riding stables over here. This is Jay McDonald, who has multiple sclerosis.
That's right.
And you've been riding at the centre for a while now?
Yes, I have. I've been riding here for about 15 months.
Right. What does it do then for you personally?
Well, for me personally, my balance is very poor. And riding actually helps my balance, and physiotherapists and people agree. And the longer I can stay reasonably well balanced, the longer I'll be able to function in society. I haven't done a great deal of riding this summer, but with an indoor school, I'm going to be able to ride regularly, and I'm going to actually be able to improve my riding.
We are getting very wet.
We are.
Shall we sort of say, let's go and have a cup of coffee?
I think that's a very good idea.
It's a really miserable day. Have you ever seen such a dejected looking man?
No.
Is that Arena Promotional Facilities? Hi there, it's Anneka Rice here from the Challenge Programme. And we were looking for some seating for a viewing gallery area. Oh, hello there. It's Anneka Rice here from the Challenge Programme.
Oh, hello there.
Hello. Could I talk to someone about long-lasting polytrack surfaces?
Christy Hat.
Christy Hats?
Yeah.
Are they riding hats?
Fellow matchmakers.
What sort of matchmaking do you do?
Riding footwear we do.
Oh, I see. I thought I'd rung up a sort of dateline agency.
No.
I gather you do jumpers and accessories and body protectors and
right
and ponies.
And you want us to give you them, is that what you want?
Yes.
Certainly can help you out there.
Steady. What's your son's name?
Daniel.
Daniel, what do you think riding does for him then?
I think it did a lot to him. I remember when Daniel started, he could actually hardly sort of sit in the horse, let alone sort of control his head and sit up and all that.
Yeah.
And that's gradually now, you know, I'm walking with him more or less, just give him a little support.
What is his condition?
Well, his CP has got cerebral palsy. And, well, he had his hips done, you know, he's just... At the moment, his plaster is all the way down his legs, and yeah.
Oh. How did you cope when it was so, you know, you were actually riding outside and it was freezing cold and raining?
Oh, you get used to it. I mean, I tell you, Daniel, he gets up every morning, Sunday morning at 6 o'clock in the morning, waiting for his ride. It's Sunday today. What time is it now? I said, oh, it's only 6 o'clock, and you go back to sleep, sort of thing, you know.
Oh, that's brilliant.
So he really, really looked forward to it, and
Like riding. Good. Well, hopefully you'll be back on a horse again soon. Yeah. Can't see your mouth down there. A bit warm. You've got the best place to be. It's got rather windy, hasn't it?
Yeah.
It may just be a few horses in a field near a prison in the middle of London, but my goodness, what effect they're having on the whole community here. This whole area here has got to be landscaped still. This area here has got 50 tons of asphalt to be laid down. Hi there. And we come into the main arena. And all over this main area, of course, has got to be the polytrack riding surface. And I must say, it's the first time over the last 4 days that I now have serious doubts whether this project will be finished in time. What on earth are we going to do with all the horses and 300 people? Some good news.
Yes.
And here it comes. This is a spillers van.
Oh my gosh.
And they have said that they will give you food for the ponies for the next year. They will feed your ponies free of charge for the next year.
Provide an indoor school to start. Oh my gosh.
And that's the first load.
Oh my gosh.
Hi, you are so kind. This is Sister Mary Joy, whose stables it is. And it's full of four-speed.
That's right, yes.
You are so kind.
Thank you very much.
Can we have a peek?
We've got a year's supply system there.
Thank you very much indeed.
Great, great pleasure for us.
Isn't that wonderful? Sister Mary, you're not allowed to cry yet. She's gone.
You better provide me with a handkerchief.
Bring on those Kleenex for this afternoon. To go, I'm very happy to say the loo's all working here.
look at them. Lovely handrails. The whole lot is absolutely pristine or nearabouts. Where have you just learnt from?
The old airing cupboard.
The old airing cup. That's going to be the old airing cupboard. No, loose. Everything designed for access in a wheelchair. Work of art. So what do you think will be the best thing about having an indoor riding school?
When it's like raining and it's wet and cold, and it'll be nice and warm.
So it'll be better when you know that it's sheltered and yeah. Every Thursday you'll be able to ride as normal. Yeah. Do you think we're going to finish it in time?
Yes, I definitely will.
Even though it is now 1 o'clock and there's only 2 hours to go, and there's an awful lot of mess back there.
You'll do it, I know you will.
Oh, such optimism, I don't share it. I haven't spoken to Sarah, our architect, for ages. You have to speak up.
Well, I don't know what to say. We're putting the floor down at the moment. We're about to tarmac at the front. The ramps are going in. There's one or two things. The carpenters have still got to carry on. They're working tremendously hard doing the most phenomenal task. But I think we might just make it.
Another layer to go on top of this. Lord Oaksey, you're happy with your commentary notes. I've never heard you do an egg and spoon race before. I'm looking forward to this, actually.
I'm very much looking forward to that. Yes, I'm aiming at 3 o'clock, are you?
Aiming for a punctual 3 o'clock. Congratulations, you finished the project.
Right.
An egg and spoon race.
On Quizzy.
Well,
I'm
what
listed
if you drop it.
My bad. The
you have to get off.
Get off and get back on again.
I need a step ladder and at least 3 strong men, honestly. Quizzy. Hi, Quizzy. We've got long to go now. Are you ready? Still won't talk to me. It's looking immaculate. Well done. I cannot believe the whole garden has been put in. And they're still putting down the next layer. And I just cannot believe in 45 minutes this is going to be finished. Like, I just can't believe it. In fact, I will go so far as to say this is going to be impossible to finish in time.
A in the centre.
We'll keep an eye on this then.
Look at this, you hardly read the watch.
2:15, and we've got to be finished by 3.
I don't know how I'm going to cope with in there. I'm just going to burst into tears.
She's gone already.
My brain!
I'm so excited getting there.
Machinery out of it! That is everybody, all right? No. This is the last piece.
Chris, we can all take our helmets off. It's no longer hard hat area.
Moment for everyone, I think, actually walking in here now. It's thanks to everybody who's sitting down by the kicking boards, who some of them have worked literally non-stop, just grabbing a few hours sleep where they can. Thank you all so much.
On behalf of Taylor Woodrow, I'd like to present this cup to Sister Mary Joy to be kept as the Taylor Woodrow Challenge Cup.
I have got one other thing I would like to present to Sister Mary Joy. We had a special delivery this morning from Buckingham Palace. We were all terribly excited when we saw the postmark. And I'd like to read it to Sister Mary Joy. I send my best wishes to the programme Challenge Anneka in the construction of an indoor riding school at Wormwood Scrubs, which provides a marvellous opportunity for disabled people to ride in the London area and will enable a number of member groups of the Riding for the Disabled Association to come together to use this wonderful new facility. Good luck, and that's Her Royal Highness the Princess Royal. And Sister Mary Joy has now got tears streaming down her cheeks. Well done. Well done, everybody here.
It's more than anyone imagined. Thanks so much, everybody.